Hey guys, welcome back. VCF9 was just launched, and what that means is I'm going to be creating a whole set of new content for it specifically. If you've ever seen my videos in the past, I'm going to cut straight to the chase with no fluff. I'll take you through the deployment and everything in between. We'll start with what's new in this video, and then we'll move on to further videos where I'll show you how to install it, how to upgrade existing environments, and what you need to think about. Cool, let's get right to it. The first thing I wanted to show you at a quick overview, and again, we will cover this in more detail and go through the process, is VMware Cloud Foundation Installer. This is the first thing that you would deploy to then get your VMware Cloud Foundation or on-prem data center running. Next is VCF Operations. The interface might look very familiar to most of you guys. This is ARIA Operations, but it's now the main tool to drive VMware Cloud Foundation. You might be wondering, what happens to SDDC Manager? In the future, SDDC Manager and its functionality will be completely collapsed into VCF Operations. It still currently exists as of this release, but it will eventually be deprecated. As you can see here, there's something also called Fleet Management, which is also its own VM that will take care of things like SSO certificates and that sort of lifecycle management. Then we've got SDDC Manager that you're well aware of by this stage. If you aren't sure about SDDC Manager, have a look at my previous videos and we'll cover a lot about SDDC Manager. Then finally, I wanted to show you what vCenter looked like. Remember, this is all vSphere 9, NSX 9, and so on. Now, what's deployed out of the box? RV was something I additionally deployed, and so are the edge nodes. They're not day zero operation, they're day N. You've got the fleet management VM that I was talking about, NSX. I've deployed one, which you do get the choice of now. But if you do want a production environment, I still recommend 3. Then Ops and the Ops Collector are deployed as part of the deployment, which I'll again take you through, SDDC Manager and vCenter. I'll quickly take you through a quick animation that shows you the process from now when you kick off the installer to then deploy. And then the next video will cover VCF Installer from start to finish. VCF Installer is like Cloud Builder. You need to have input to have some output. What that means is you put in all the information that you want to deploy your environment with. As you can see on the screen here, this is just a snippet. You still have to do all those IP addresses and all that sort of stuff that you used to do with Cloud Builder, pump it into VCF Installer, and then it will deploy the environment for you. What you see on screen here is just a quick snippet. As I said, we'll go into VCF Installer and go from start to finish of a deployment of a management domain and a Cloud Foundation domain. Like I said, this was only intended as a quick overview. There's still a bunch more that's new with the product or the product set that we couldn't cover in a single video. For example, multi-tenancies through and through VCF9 now, as well as the cloud consumption interface or the consumption interface and the way you should be driving your modern private cloud. We will cover all of that again in heaps more detail. I want to get into the nitty and gritty of stuff to show you some real value of the product. For now, that's all I've got, and stay tuned for the next video to go through the first initial build process.